Hey, it's Rhonda Britten here, and I have been just getting a nudge and another nudge and another nudge to read my book, Fearless Living, out loud. So, Fearless Living is my first book that was published in 2001, and it's been, I think it's had four editions, and this is the 10th anniversary edition, where it has a group guide. And it's sold over 120,000 copies in like 16 or 18 countries. And it is the basis of all the work that I do on how people master fear. And I've been getting the nudge to read it out loud to you. So, in case you've never read it or not sure what Fearless Living's about, you can listen and enjoy. And if you're an old timer and have been in Fearless Living for a while and your life has changed, then let this be a place where you can go deeper. So I'm just going to read a little bit every day, and together we're going to get through the whole book. And I'm really excited because I've been getting this nudge for a while. And today I went, "You just do it, Rhonda Britten. You just sit down and do it." And so today I'm doing it. I'm going to start today, Fearless Living, and I am going to start with the inscription that I wrote, and then I'm going to go to the preface. So Fearless Living. Live Without Excuses and Love Without Regret by Rhonda Britten. Is the inscription inside the book. My mother wasn't able to live her newfound freedom for long, yet by her example, I was able to pick up where she left off. This work is my gift to her. Thank you for giving me the courage to live fearlessly. I love you, Mom. And I think what I'm going to have to do is put on my reading glasses or take these glasses off so I can read better. So I'm going to read the preface and we'll see how far I get if I get passed into another chapter. But I think we'll just start with the preface. We'll start with I'm on page, well, the preface is like page X, one, like page four. Preface from Fearless Living. Since Fearless Living was first published 10 years ago, there is one thing I've heard over and over again. It doesn't matter if I'm in a big city or a small town. It doesn't matter if I'm coaching a man or a woman. It doesn't matter if that person is 35 or 63 years old, a millionaire or barely making ends meet. Most people do not want to admit fear is controlling their life. I'm going to say that one again. Most people do not want to admit fear is controlling their life. I get it. Who wants to admit they aren't in control? My response to people who say fear isn't running their lives? Well, that's fabulous. Congratulations, I say. So, can you say you're sorry without hesitation? Forgive when needed? Ask for what you want without blaming, complaining, or whining? Can you tell the truth? And how about putting boundaries in place? P.S. When I normally give that quiz, most people fail. You can be vulnerable with the people you love, trust yourself, and take action. Can you say yes when you mean yes and no when you mean no? Never feel resentful or feel taken advantage of. Feel loved and appreciated by the people in your life. Can you accept compliments? Have the tough and uncomfortable conversations, and are on your way to accomplish whatever you set out to do. And you can do all this, whether the economy is on the rocks, your spouse just left you, or your small business is going to shut its doors. Their response, well, no. That's what I thought. Hopefully fear is not running all the areas of your life, but in some area, whether it is your drive for success, your desire for more love, your relationship with your body, and so on, fear is insidious, running the show. Let me read that again. Fear is insidiously running the show. How do I know? Because the area of your life that you shy away from, worry about, ignore, give up on, get frustrated with, feel helpless about, that's where fear is having its way with you. Now add in a bad economy, sinking real estate values, and a soaring unemployment rate, and fear becomes palatable. In this unprecedented time, fear is more visible than ever before. It's hard to ignore. It's everywhere. But that's actually good news. What you can see, you can face and then master. Your fears did not begin with a housing crisis. They did not start when you lost your job. Your fears may be more evident at certain times in your life, but you've had them all along. I'm not talking about fear of snakes or heights or flying. Those are physical fears. Fears related to our bodily safety and security are very survival. I'm talking about the emotional fears that have been forming since the day you were born and that drive many of your everyday encounters. The fear of being rejected, seen as stupid, labeled incompetent, or being unlovable. These fears are the reason you give up on yourself and tell yourself you should wait or you shouldn't push too hard. It doesn't have to be that way. I can help. This is what I know. I have seen over and over again with each person I've had the privilege to work with that once you recognize, admit, and understand how your core fear influences your life, it no longer has power over you. You will be able to see it for what it is, a security system that puts your emotional safety above your desire to risk. Fear will always choose the known over the unknown. In its desire to keep you safe, it would rather you complain than take action, be confused than crystal clear, be isolated instead of reaching out. Fear would rather you focus on having it all versus celebrating the baby steps of success. Think you don't have talent instead of practicing discipline. Comparing yourself to anyone about everything instead of shoring up your own life. Fear wants you to believe that fundamentally there is something wrong with you. And that's why you can't go for it, have it, do it, or be it, whatever it is. Because fear loves you, and yes, I did say fear loves you, it wants to keep you safe. And safety looks very different for each person. Last week, I coached a woman who jumps at the chance to fling herself out of planes or surf the biggest waves. To the world, she appears fearless, unafraid. Yet after a few minutes of coaching, it was clear fear still had a hold of her. She went from one relationship to the next, afraid to create true intimacy. That fear ran her life and fueled her desire for adrenaline. Sure, she looked fearless, but inside, when it came to love, she was anything but. So do not let appearances fool you. Just because some people look like they have it all together doesn't mean they don't have some insidious emotional fears working somewhere. Once you understand how those fears work, there'll be nothing to be afraid of. I absolutely know this to be true. From the day I wrote this book to now, I know this to be true. The number one comment I hear from someone who reads Fearless Living and does each and every exercise is, "Now I understand why my life is the way it is. It all makes sense." And that is said without guilt or shame or blame. It just is. When you see fear for what it is, you can do something about it. Yes, we may be experiencing the worst economic times in our lifetime, but it doesn't have to be the worst time of your life. In fact, it is a huge opportunity. Fear for the first time is a collective event. People are showing their fear-based underbellies. It's the perfect time to figure out this fear thing once and for all. It's the best time to become fearless. I designed Fearless Living to help you triumph over the fear. Wait a second. That prevents you from living the life your soul intended. As of this writing, thousands of people have attested to the life-changing payoffs acquired by following the Fearless Living program. Instead of theories and concepts, Fearless Living entails practical applications for real life situations that will work for you. In part one of Fearless Living, you will learn how your individualized fears operate, perpetuate, and manifest. In part two, you will discover the power behind your day-to-day actions and uncover how they sustain your fears or help you move beyond them. Fearless Living works. It worked 10 years ago. It works today. It will work for you. Let's get fearless together. And that is the preface of my book, Fearless Living. Now, I would be happy to read the little part of the book right here before I get into my story, because I think I will leave that until tomorrow, because that is a few pages. And if you want to follow along with me while I'm reading the book day after day in the next few weeks, grab the copy of Fearless Living, 10th Anniversary Edition, and you can read right alongside with me. And of course, ask me questions. So I'm going to look to see if anybody has any questions for me. But I will read this little part. It's I can't remember the name of the little formalized name of this page, but it's between the preface and my story. And this kind of sums it all up. Fear is a killer. It kills hopes. It kills dreams. It kills careers. It kills relationships. In a flash, it killed my parents. It almost killed me. How is it killing you? Fear kills dreams. Fear kills relationships. Fear kills careers. In a flash, it killed my parents, and it almost killed me. How is it killing you? So go ahead and write in the comments below how fear is holding you back. Go ahead and just tell me how fear is holding you back. I want to hear from you how fear is stopping you from going for that dream, living that intention, making that goal happen, loving that relationship, releasing into forgiveness, really making your dreams happen. So look back on this past year and ask yourself, how has fear held me back? And again, you're soon going to learn that fear doesn't show up the way you think fear does. Fear shows up. You don't have to say, I'm sorry, I'm afraid, or I'm scared. You say a lot of other words that really point to fear. So go ahead and type in what your fear has holding your back. How has fear been holding you back? Go ahead and type that in the comments below. How has fear been holding you back? And then tomorrow we'll meet here again and I will read you my story. And we're going to read Fearless Living day after day as my Christmas gift, my happy holidays, my Kwanzaa, my happy Hanukkah gift to you. Meet me here tomorrow. But before you leave, go ahead and write down right now, what is the fear and how is that fear holding you back? What aren't you doing in your life that you know you want to do? So what is it that you want to do in your life that you are not allowing yourself to do, that you're shooting yourself, that you're telling yourself, not yet, not the time, not something, not right now, can't, don't have the time, don't have the money, don't. Write it down. I want to hear from you. And let me just look at if there's any questions. People are saying hi. Heather writes, fear has held me back from launching Javita, fear of failure to succeed. Ooh, I like that, Heather. Great. Kelly, I want to hear from you. You're the best, Rhonda, she says. You've taught me so much. Thank you, Kelly. Tell me your fear. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Heather. Del Toro. Mwah. He says, Rhonda Britten, love you. You're the best on the planet. Thank you, my sweet friend. And whether you're watching this live or watching the replay, go ahead and in the comments section, tell me how fear has stopped you. And then every day until we're complete, I'll be reading Fearless Living to you. Meet me back here tomorrow. Until then, be fearless. Be fearless.